Integration with database with UiPath is pretty simple. All it needs is the six activities that are listed here on this page. So you have activity called connect, you have activity called disconnect, then we have activity called execute none query, execute query, insert and start transaction. Right? These are the different database packages operations that you can perform. What you need to do before you connect to database. So that's another question, and that requires few details about how your database works, right? You should be able to integrate any kind of database which supports OLEDB or ODBC based drivers, right? That means it has provided an open source bridge to communicate and connect between different applications. And that's how we, in the past, say for example, if we want to integrate PHP with MySQL, what we used to do? We are using MySQL connectivity, connection drivers, right? If we are using Access database, we are using ODBC driver provided by the Access. If we want to use SQL Server, what we are doing? We are using a driver provided by the SQL Server to connect, right? Similar to that, Amit, you're saying something? Sorry.
Sorry, my mistake.
Okay. Similar to that, how you perform database connection in different programming languages like Java, PHP, Python, you should be able to connect database in UiPath in exactly the same way. All you need to understand is a different connection strings and provider. And if you understand which provider will work for which database and what will be the connection string type, you should be able to connect any databases, right? So let's look at the detail of these activity, what these activities will do. These activities are pretty much standard, right? And you should be able to understand by looking at their names, right? So let's quickly move to detail about this activity. So the first activity that we use is a connect, right? This activity requests a connection string, quite obvious, because it need to know which database it need to be connect and what is the provider name, because for the different provider, it has to perform different operation. So in most of the cases, you can say in 100% cases, you have to provide a connection string, which can be built inside a UiPath Studio, or if you have connection string given by your database team. So you can use that. So you have to provide a connection string, which must contain a data source, username is quite obvious, and then the password. This activity will return you a database connection variable, which is nothing but a data connection object, which will be used further for all other activities, right, to perform the task. Then you have a disconnect activity, which is nothing but it disconnects the database so that your database will be in persistent state. So we should always disconnect when we connect. Otherwise, what will happen is there will be a lot many open connections and sometimes it may cause a problem. So for the best practices, when we connect and when we are done with the operation, we should disconnect, right? Then we have execute, and we have two kinds of execute. One is execute none query and execute query. And when, which one is to use? Execute none query are those query which do not return any result set. When I say which do not return any result set, that means it performs certain operation on the numbers of rows in a database. Say for example, if you want to update data into database, what you should be able to do is you should be able to run an update query. It will not return the rows which are updated, but it will return the number of rows which are updated. And that's the difference between execute none query and query. So any query which will return a result and where you are seeking a result, you have to use execute query. And any query which you are, not trying to get a result, you can use execute none query. All right. Then you have an insert activity. Insert activity is really, really useful. This activity inserts a data table record into existing data table. For this, you need to provide the table name and data table variable. You don't need to write insert statement. Here, you need to make sure that the columns of the data table should match with a table inside your database so that they can be inserted. If it is not there, you need to perform some manual operations on the data table first, and then you should be able to insert it directly. This will be useful when you need to insert a bulk amount of data in a one go in a database, right? Say for example, inserting a record from CSV file to database, you need to use the insert statement. Or if you want to do it one by one, what you need to do is you need to use execute none query inside a for loop of a CSV file to insert one by one. That's the difference between execute none query and insert statement here, right? So this insert is used to insert the data using the data table, and that execute none query insert the data using the insert SQL statement, right? And then we have a start transaction. Start transaction is nothing but when you want your workflow to be standard and it should follow the ACID properties, right? So ACID property, you understand, right? So your database has to be in consistent state. It has to, you know, complete all the transactions before it commit and all those kind of stuff. So in those cases, if you have multiple operations to perform, so you can start inside a start transaction state so that when all the operations are performed, you will be able to complete that individually. So we'll look at the options in Studio and there will explain you. So what are the steps you need to follow now, right? You have 6 activities available in a UiPath to communicate and connect with the databases, right? Let's talk about what are the steps that you need to follow. So step number one that you need to follow is you have to install a database package from the managed packages, right? And that's obvious because it gives you all the activities which are required for connecting with the database and performing certain operation. In step number two, because now you have database package available, so you should be able to drag and drop all those 6 activities. You can see that in a screen at the right side. Now, in the UiPath Studio, the first thing that you need to use is a connect activity in the sequence. This activity will request a connection string, right? Because you need to tell which database need to be connected and what is the provider detail, right? For example, if you want to connect to MySQL or any variant of MySQL, which is MariaDB as well, right? So you should be able to using the connection string written at the bottom. So all you need to give is server name, port, database, user ID, and the password. Using this connection string, you should be able to connect with a database. So this is step number 3. After that, once you are done with connection, in step number 4, I am specifically showcasing you the provider name. Sometime it depends, so you should be able to give it, right? Now, in step number 5, you have to store the output, database connection output, into some variable, because that will be used in all your future operations. Say for example, if you want to select the data, you need to pass the database connection name. Similarly, if you want to insert the data, you need to give database connection name, right? So you have to store that into a variable. Once you store that variable into a, you know, variable, now you can see that connection has been established. Not a single warning is visible in UiPath Studio. You should be able to track the activity that you need to perform. So you can execute query, right? Or you can execute none query as well. And based on the type of operation that you are following, you should be able to store the result. So if you are using execute query, it will return you a data table. So you should be able to receive the data from a select query into a data table. And once that is received in a data table, you know how easy it is to work on data table. So you should be able to write that into Excel, write that into CSV file, and perform certain operations. Okay. So this should be the next step. And then step number 8, is nothing but talking about how you should be able to write the data which is coming after the execute to in the Excel file. Okay, so this is how it would be look like. Now I just wanted to help you understand, here is different database connectivity will require different connection history. So the example that is currently shown on this PPT is example taken from MySQL server, right? What about if you want to connect SQL server, right? So you should be able to do the same thing. Only thing that will change is the connection string. So if you see the connection string here is different than the connection string that I have shown couple of pages back, right? So that's the only difference between this. So with this, I'll stop presenting the slide. I'll go to the UiPath Studio and help you to understand how you should be able to connect, communicate with the databases, right? So let me stop this presentation. And then I have an example already created here. So I'll open this example and then, sorry, not with the Visual Studio, but UiPath Studio. Okay, so for sake of simplicity, I am using this. First example I am using is using MySQL. So this is I have installed MySQL server on my machine and I having a local instance which is running here, username root, and the server detail is localhost this. So let me click on this. Just wanted to showcase you what all tape. What I did is I have created two tables here. One is authors and one is a post. So I have created two tables here and you should be able to see those tables here, right? So this is a table and these are the columns. So what we're trying to do here, we are trying to read the information from the post table, and that will look how we should be able to, you know, use in a UiPath Studio. Okay, so I just wanted to give you a brief intro about what is our schema, how tables look like, right? And you should be able to do it. So I'll send you all these files, you know, so you should be able to replicate at your end. So let me quickly open the database example. Right, so we have here, we have database example. All right, so as I explained you, first thing that you need to do is drop a connect. So if you want, what I can do is I can create in front of you so that you understand how exactly it has to be done step by step. So first thing that you need to do is use a connect, right? So when you do this, it will throw you error message saying that it is provider name and everything is not supported. So you need to click on configure database connection, right? Click on the connection wizard, and here for MySQL connectivity, there is no default driver provided by the Microsoft. So you need to select others, and then in the database provider, you need to select .NET Framebase database. Okay. Guys, do you understand the concept of DNS? I mean, just asking, so that otherwise I need to explain how DNS can be configured. Because connecting with MySQL, we need to use the MySQL ODBC driver, right? And for my ODBC driver, what you need to do is you need to install MySQL server first, and then you also need to install, you know, a component which is given by MySQL server, which is this one. So this is a ODBC driver, connector ODBC. So this is you need to install, right? And make sure you
locally install that we can utilize the same thing, right?
Yeah, even if your server is at the remote location but you are running a script on your machine, right? You say, for example, your database is hosted remotely on some XYZ server, But for connection to happen, you need a connectivity driver on your machine so that UiPath Studio can use the DLL and the config provided by this connector. So basically, this connector has to be set up locally. Got my point? So this is you need to install. And once you install this, what? Let me close this. So I'll help you explain step by step. Okay. So then you have to click on configure first. Okay. Then you need to click connection wizard. Okay. And in the data source, you need to select others. Look it very carefully. And then in the data provider, you need to select .NET framework data provider for ODBC. Okay. In the connection properties, you need to select use connection string. And there, if you know it, how it is, you should be able to use that directly. If it is given by your, you know, usually given by your DBA or somebody, so you can use that directly. But if you don't know how it is, so you should be able to click on build. Okay. And in build, it will ask you for what is a data source. So we don't have any DNS file name. So we'll click here and then we'll click new. So it will come this as a, this window will come. And then what we'll do, you need to click on next. And then it will ask you for what kind of data source you need to create. So for example, we are connect. I have lot many drivers installed on my machine. So you need to select the one which supports the ANSI driver. So click on this one and then finish. And then it will see. So this is the connector I was talking about. So you see, UiPath has communicated with the connection driver that you have installed, right? This is the connection driver that you have installed. Okay. And what you need to give is, let's give a name. Called, you can give any name here. So it's basically say it's UiPath demo. Okay. And in the server, I am running locally. So it should be 127.0.0.1. And the port width is a default. And in user, I am using a root user. So, and then you should be able to use the credential here and test it. So connection is successful. Once the connection is successful, you should be able to see all the databases here. So I need to select the database name is UiPath. And when you click OK, and when you click OK, sorry, I've tested it, click OK. So you will see a connection string has been created. So if you know the connection string, you can directly type it. But if you don't know it, you have to build it like this way. So you have, you know, okay. So don't say, and now again, I test to connection. Sorry, what happened? Oh, sorry, it is using this. Following the same step again. I think it is not saved somehow. So it's ANSI driver and then finish. And then whatever the name you need to give and then server detail. One and then user should be user here. And password should be your root password of the database. And test it. Connection is successful and you should be able to see this. So that's what you need to do. Okay. And you need to select this one. And you can close this now. So that's how you need to configure it. You got any issues here? It's basically how you configure your ODBC driver. So if you search and Google it, you should be able to find lot many article on this, lot many different ways of doing it, right? But the only thing that you need to take care is you need to understand how connectivity works. Okay, so the first thing that you need to do is connect, and you need to store the database connection into SQL, a database connection variable. I am just printing here so that we understand that this is a database connection of type of object. And then next, what you need to do is, when the connection is established, you need to use a execute query. So in the execute query, what I am doing, select star from the posts. So which is nothing but I am trying to read all these data from here. Okay, so, and then in the execute query, you will see that it's asking for the connection string. So you can use a new connection if you want to do, or if you want to use the existing connection. So I have to use the existing connection. Connection variable is SQL, which is coming from here. So the same variable is used here. So connection has been established, and the result of this query will be stored in a data table. Data table name is DTPost. And once the data is in a DTPost, we should be able to write the data into Excel file, or whatever the operation we want to perform in UiPath, we should be able to do it. So for example, if we need to loop over the post, go into different applications, copy paste it, we should be able to do it. Or whatever the business logic you want to do, you should be able to do it. So let's quickly run this. So let me delete this file just to help you understand, and then run this. Right, and now when you refresh it, you should be able to see a file here which contains all the data coming from database. Got my point? Guys, any doubt here in how to use database connectivity? We are good here?
Yeah.
I think it's a pretty easy. All you need to do is a connect, and then you need to execute query. So if you want to, you know, delete from, say for example, if you want to delete it. So let's, you know, comment this, disable this activity, and disable this as well. Okay. And now, say for example, I want to delete something. So, execute none query. So again, we, in the connection string, what we need to do is given a SQL, okay? And here in the edit query, we need to write, what is the syntax for deleting? So delete star from posts, right? That's how we should be able to delete it. Table name is posts. So, okay, and it will return number of affected rows. So we'll say row count. And we should be able to log it just to understand how many records are deleted. So row count dot to string plus has been deleted. Okay, save it, run it. Okay, so it does not support the syntax. Syntax is different. So for deleting, we need to use a different query. I think it supports delete. I can use, let's edit this query. Can anyone help me with the delete syntax? how it works.
We will use select, I think.
Sorry?
Delete star from select and we write name of the database.
Name of the database is already here, so we don't delete. I think this is how it should be. Different database, you know, SQL addition has different syntax, so that's the problem. So it's basically, it should be, as per my understanding, it should be delete from table name, where it's delete from table name, and it should be support like something where 1 = 1. That's how it should work. Let's see it. Yeah. So you can see 100 records has been deleted now. Sorry for the confusion, because different, you know, query construct works in a different way. Got the point? So it has returned number of rows which are affected due to the execute none query operation, right? So you should be able to handle this. Yeah, Gris, let me know what is your doubt. Is you saying something? Chris, we are not able to hear you. Okay, all right, we'll take that question later. So that's how it has to be done. And similarly, if we need to connect to the SQL server, what all things we need to do? So the only difference would be all other steps will remain same. Okay, all other steps like these will remain same. The only thing that you need to change is a connection configuration. And here you should be able to use this connection string directly, or you can use a connection wizard as well. So it's pretty simple. You need to use, you know, my Microsoft SQL Server, and then you need to refresh the detail here. So sometime when you click refresh, and then your server name will be displayed, and by selecting that, you should be able to test the connection and use it. So you need to follow this step by step operation, and this is pretty much same. So it's nothing new. Sometime it doesn't respond in time, but that's how it works. So basically it's using a system to identify what all servers are running on my machine, right? So that's okay. So this is how you should be able to, and when you run it, you can be able to check if the connection has been done. So let's look at the connection string. So this is how it should be. Data source is your server name. I'm not using any credential and password because it's using a Windows authentication, and that's the reason no user ID and password is given. But if you want to use user ID and password, you have to give those details as well. Sometimes you can also give, you know, database name here if you want to connect to database directly, like database name equal to master, right? So those you should be able to do that. So it's all about how you want to connect, right? It depends on your system configuration as well. And that's the reason I do not wanted to give the more information on it. But the moment you are able to connect it, you should be able to use it. And if you want to connect Oracle databases again, so you should be able to do it exactly in the same way. The only thing that will differ is a connection wizard. And in the data source, you need to select the Oracle. And then follow the steps for the connection wizard, right? All right, so pretty much good with the MySQL database connectivity wizard. and we have a complete what I could say is assignment based on this. So if you go to the module 8, we have assignment for the code activity. So these are the two things that you need to perform. One is using a Python code to calculate the last day of a month and invoke the code in UiPath, and then integrate PowerShell in a UiPath to get list of stopped Windows processes and print the process name and status using UiPath. So that you need to do. So you need to use a PowerShell to get the status, put that into a data table or file, and then print it using the UiPath. So that's assignment. And then in the hands-on material, we have a step-by-step document to install with a MySQL server. So download link, how to install, and the connection string and everything. And it's a step-by-step, it is described. So I'll send you this document to follow and create this example, right? So you should be able to complete this. And then similarly, we have an example for, if you go at the end, it contains every example. So it contains example of insert, example of delete, example of update and everything. And if you want to connect the SQL server, what are the steps that you need to follow? So click here and all those, when selection is successful, and then you should be able to step. So I'll send this document and you should be able to follow this and you should be able to connect. Try at least with two databases so that you understand the concept, right? Try to install a SQL Server Express on your machine and MySQL and experiment with it. One more thing I wanted to discuss before we'll go on a lunch break. And when we come from the lunch break, we'll discuss a small topic, which is called UiPath Object Repository, right? That's the other thing that we need to discuss, and that's pending for last couple of, lessons. So I need to complete that as well. So let's quickly look at one more example before we, go to that object repository part. Okay. Many time you will, be asked with a question, can we connect Excel as a database, right? So the answer is yes, we should be able to connect Excel as a database. Then what is the benefit of connecting an Excel file as a database, right? So there are a lot of benefit. When you connect Excel as a database, operations will become much more faster. I mean, 10 times faster sometime. So you need to look at the way how you should be able to connect Excel as a database. So let's take an example of that. I have also created an example where I am connecting an Excel file as a database. Okay. Right. So let me open this. It's a basic example. Similar to what we have a connect and then we have execute query, right? And we are fetching the row count from the data table. What we are doing here, we have a Excel file. This is a sample Excel file, which contains two columns, name and country, right? And data is in a sheet one. And now look at the connection configuration. So here we are using a provider is equal to Microsoft AC OLEDB 12.0. This is the old way to connect with Excel databases. And those who are coming from C# or VB.NET programming, they understand how it works. Because this is how we used to connect in Office 2007. So for this Excel as a database to work, you need to install minimum Microsoft Access Database Engine 2010. That will be required. Otherwise, you won't be able to find this provider on your machine. So that's the only common issue you will get with this example. So you need to install this one. So you can, search for this Microsoft Access Database Engine 2010. You will get the first link and download it and install it. That will provide you the required drivers. And then when you configure the connection, next is execute a query. So in the executing a query, we are giving the connection string, right? Here, and this connection string will be used in executing a query. So the same connection string here. And then we have this select star from this, right? Here I am taking a example which is more complicated. So here what I am doing is I am running a query which have where condition and it's looking for seat number 1. So this is a variable, defined variable in a Excel. So UiPath should be able to understand that accordingly. And if you need to understand more in terms of what all variables you use, you need to read Microsoft documentation for that. But let's just take this example as here in this case, seat 1 will become table, right? And it will read the data where name equal to Sarath. That means column will become, these will become column. So it will read all the data which contains filter on the basis of name. So name is this one. So let this name here. Okay. And row count should be here. And save it, run it. So row count is 3. You can see row count is 3. Reason being, there are 3 records with my name in this particular table, right? Deleting certain columns based on multiple condition is pretty easy when you use Excel as a database. Many times we have to perform, you know, identifying a duplicate, performing, you know, aggregation like, you know, sum and all those things. In those scenario, connecting Excel as a database is a good way to do it. It is a faster, efficient way to do. Right? Any doubt on this example? How you should be able to connect Excel as a database?
Yes, Satish, how can we configure connection? Maybe let's say.
So here we are using a provider called Microsoft ASC OLEDB 12.0. That's a fix that you need to use. This is a static part. Till here it is a static part. Okay. And there we are using an ampersand and we have given Excel path. Excel path is nothing but a variable that we have used here. This is the Excel path. So Excel path is the file name, which is this one. So you should be able to, I just, you know, make that in that way so that we should be able to dynamically connect to any, you know, any file. Otherwise, if you don't need this, you should be able to directly hard code this here. So you should be able to write, you know, the file name directly. So these are the two things that one need to consider. And you need to use extender property Excel 2.0 and these things will remain same. Everything will remain same. The only thing that will change, this will remain same. The only thing that will change is Excel path. If you want to use it dynamically, use ampersand, then Excel path and ampersand. If you do not want to use it directly, so you need to remove this and type the file name directly here like this. Okay. Yeah. And for this, you need to download this engine as well. So let me showcase you that as well. And this is really, really good, you know. So go to here and it's a straightforward, it's a pretty useful, you can get it directly. So if you come here, you will get this. So you need to install it and download in a language. And only thing that you need to select is you make sure that which type of is a 32-bit and it's a 64-bit. So you need to look at your machine and accordingly you need to download and install. Okay. All right. So basically, keep in mind, every time you connect something as a database, you need to work with the connector, right? And different provider provide different connectors. MySQL will provide their connector, Excel will provide their connector, Oracle will provide their connector. So those connector has to be installed on your machine first, first thing first. And once connector is installed and you are able to test the connection using that connector, you should be able to connect to databases. Many times I have seen people, you know, trying to, you know, debug the UiPath code multiple times when the connection is being not made, right? So first thing that you need to debug is why connection is not being made. So you need to look at the connector settings and properties instead of, you know, checking the code in a UiPath Studio, right? All right, guys. So this is all about database connections. Any other thing before I move to next concept, which is object repository?
Yeah, I think that's all.